visible results. At the 2005 summit, we reaffirmed our commitment to global partnership for development as stated in the Millennium Declaration, the Monterrey Consensus, and the Johannesburg Implementation Plan. We fully agree that every country bears the responsibility for its own development, which depends mainly on national policies and strategies. We also agree that global actions are necessary as a support to national efforts. Some regions need more shared responsibility than others in order to achieve the projected targets. Africa, where the situation remains alarming, requires special attention. For this purpose, we endorse the call for renewed commitment to the implementation of the UN Millennium Development Goals, and we await the forthcoming high-level dialogue on financing for development, which is expected to bring specific results. Excellencies, UN involvement in Africa, including Sudan, remains of exceptional importance. The situation in Darfur is extremely critical and alarming. Member states must reunite once again and provide support to UN activities in order to respond to the challenges on the ground. The Middle East situation continues to be an issue of utmost concern. People in the Middle East deserve to live free from fear and threats. The Republic of Macedonia supports the efforts of the Quartet and the Roadmap. A renewed peace process is also of utmost urgency. The situation in Lebanon also remains high on the international agenda. Recently, the Republic of Macedonia joined the UN forces in that area by sending military officers within the UN mission. Since the very beginning, the Republic of Macedonia has been part of the international anti-terrorist coalition in Iraq and Afghanistan. The Republic of Macedonia fully supports the unity of Iraq. We also support the recent UN Security Council resolution regarding an extended role of the organization in Iraq. Building peace and democracy in these two countries remains as key challenges both for the international community and for the Iraqis and Afghanis themselves. Honorable President, the Republic of Macedonia continues on its path towards a functional multi-ethnic democracy. There are many challenges on this path that we should tackle and obligations we must fulfill. We are committed to comprehensive reforms in all segments of Macedonian society in order to obtain the date for the beginning of pre-accession negotiations for membership in the European Union in 2008. At the same time, bearing in mind the successful reforms that we have been implementing for years, we are deeply convinced that it would be realistic to obtain the invitation for membership of the Republic of Macedonia in the NATO at the following summit of this organization, scheduled for April 2008 in Bucharest. The Southeast Europe region has passed a long way in the past decade. We are all striving towards the common goal of European and Euro-Atlantic integration, which is a strong driving force in terms of reforms and final stabilization of the region. The Republic of Macedonia remains firmly committed to good neighborly relations and regional cooperation, whereby we believe that dialogue is of key importance for all outstanding issues in the interest of everyone in the region. We continue to support the efforts of the international community regarding the resolution of the status of Kosovo. At this stage, the Republic of Macedonia hopes that the next round of negotiations and consultations led by the Troika shall bring closer the positions of both parties. We also endorse the position according to which the resolution of the Kosovo issue should be formulated within a reasonable time frame in the best interest of the stability in the region and its Euro-Atlantic perspective. In this context, I would like to underline in particular that we do not agree with the recently mentioned idea of partition of Kosovo according to ethnic lines, since this may provoke serious negative implications for the entire region. The issue of the technical demarcation of our northern border with Kosovo according to a predefined procedure and agenda remains a top priority for the Republic of Macedonia. At the end, Mr. President, allow me to assure you that we shall spare no efforts to translate our words into actions so that people across the world may be convinced in our commitment to the respect and implementation of the principles and values enshrined in the UN Charter. And finally, with or without point of order, the name of my country is Republic of Macedonia and will be Republic of Macedonia. Thank you.
On behalf of the General Assembly and on my own name, I wish to thank the President of the Republic of Macedonia for the statement just made. May I request representatives to remain seated while the Deputy Secretary General and I escort the President.
L'Assemblée va mettre...